We're here at the Edmunds test track, and we've brought our Model 3 back for another go. Last time we were here, we measured its stopping distance on the standard 18-inch tires at 133 feet, which was a little longer than we would have liked, but not that far out of the ballpark. But subsequent to that, others tested their cars and got numbers in the 150-foot range, really out to lunch. And since then, Tesla has responded with a new software update that's supposed to improve the stopping distance. How much? We don't know. We're here to find out. This car's configuration is identical to last time. Same 18-inch wheels, same pads and rotors. The only thing that's different is the software upgrade. Let's hit it. 60 miles an hour. Boom. There's a lot more initial bite. It gets with the program right away. And the stop about 10 or 11 feet shorter. And nothing but a software change, which means the ABS or the handoff between regenerative braking and friction braking has been altered. And that's really the only thing it could be, because the tires are the same. The pads and rotors are the same, the car's the same, the track's the same. So yeah, it looks like software made a difference. It's hard to know what's going on exactly. So it could be the ABS timing, which seems unlikely because that's pretty well known. But also, since this is an electric car and a rear-wheel drive one at that, there's this desire to harvest as much electricity using regenerative braking as you can. And so the handoff to the rear friction brakes may not have been as immediate as it needed to be for a panic stop. That's the theory I'm operating on. I'm not sure if we'll get confirmation of that from Tesla, but certainly that seems likely. But we don't know for certain. The results are pretty clear. Today's test with revised software, it resulted in a stop that was 10 feet shorter. Our first stop was 123 feet versus 133 feet last time. The second stop was even a little bit better than that at 122 feet. So 10 or 11 feet, that's a pretty significant difference. And really nothing on the car has changed except software. And it wasn't just about the number, 122, 123 feet, it was also the feel. The initial bite when I got onto the pedal feels much more positive than before. And throughout the stop, there's just a nice, consistent deceleration feel, which was lacking last time. So yeah, it's a lot better in terms of how the ABS works in a panic stop situation. So this story is a good news, bad news story in a way, because the good news is over-the-air software updates are awesome. We didn't have to go to the dealer to get this reflashed. It just happened. But the flip side is, why was this necessary at all? I worked at two automakers' proving grounds for a total of 17 years, and it's really hard for me to understand how this wasn't discovered in the testing phase and implemented before production started. It's great that there's over-the-air software updates, but it's kind of odd that it needs to happen this way. If you already own a Tesla Model 3, this won't be a problem because the last software update included the same fix that we've got. And if you're going to buy one or you're on the waiting list, this will be included in future production vehicles. For more information on how we test cars and to see more videos from the Edmunds Test Track, subscribe to our YouTube channel.